Quiz Academy. So let's move on to the topic Tanabe Suganam diagram. So we discussed orbital diagram. So in orbital diagram, one main limitation was there. It couldn't explain the low spin octahedral complexes, low spin complexes. So Tanabe Suganam diagram can explain both high spin and low spin complexes electronic transitions. So what is Tanabe Suganam diagram? It is a graph or plot between E by B versus delta O by B. So what is E by B and delta O by B? So E by B means E is the term energy and B is Raka parameter. So what is Raka parameter? Raka parameter contains A, B and C. So Raka parameters are A, B and C. These are some constants measuring value. For what? The inter-electronic repulsion. So for inter-electronic repulsion value, to measure the inter-electronic repulsion, we use Raka parameters called A, B and C. But in Tanabe Suganam diagram, we need only one Raka parameter, that is B. So B has the importance in Tanabe Suganam diagram. So in TS diagram, we use B, and B is the Raka parameter which measures the value of inter-electronic repulsion between two terms having same symmetry. So B is the Raka parameter which measures the inter-electronic repulsion between two terms having same symmetry. Two terms having same symmetry. So two terms having same symmetry will have a repulsion. So that repulsion can be measured using Raka parameter B. So that Raka parameter is used in Tanabe Suganam diagram. So E is the energy term and B is the inter-electronic repulsion. And delta O we know, CFSE or LFSE. LFSE means ligand field stabilization energy. It is also known as CFSE, crystal field stabilization energy. So CFSE by again Raka parameter. So what is Tanabe Suganam diagram? It will look like, so TS diagram will look like this. This is taken as zero, the ground state reference. State energy level, then one line will be bending and like this, so another will be crossing. So this is the general form of TS diagram, and here in y axis what is the parameter? E by B is taken on y axis, and here delta O by B. So on y axis E by B measure is taken and delta O by B is taken on x axis. So this is the general form of Tanabe Suganam diagram, and we will see the detailed structure of Tanabe Suganam diagram. So TS diagram contains E by B versus delta O by B, in which B is the Raka parameter which measures the inter-electronic repulsion between two terms having same symmetry. And delta O LFSE, and both high spin and low spin complexes can be explained through TS diagram, while in orbital diagram only high spin complexes are explained. And 10 dq greater than electronic repulsion equations means what? This TS diagram can be explained when the 10 dq, the energy, the difference in energy is greater than the electronic repulsion. So if the 10 dq is greater than the electronic repulsion energy, then TS diagram can be used. But in orbital diagram, we can't use in these equations where when 10 dq is greater than electronic repulsion. So that's the another benefit of TS diagram. And this is another point, predict position of transition. So TS diagram can predict the position of transitions, and ground state used as constant reference. That's why I used 0 here, maybe 3 T1G. Let's, for example, we are taking 3 T1G. So this is taken, the ground state is taken as the constant reference for TS diagram. In orbital diagram, we have seen like this. So this, let this be 3F. Then what? 3 transplicatings. So T1G, T2G and A2G. So here this is not taken as 0. So this is not the constant reference. But here 3 T1G is taken as constant reference. And another term will be plotted here. E by V versus delta O by V. So this is the Tanabe-Sugano diagram of D2 complex. So Tanabe-Sugano diagram is what? The E by V versus delta O by V plot. So in Y axis, E by V. E energy term and V Rata parameter. And X axis, delta O by V. Or we can say DQ by V. 10 DQ. Delta O is 10 DQ. So DQ by V also is right. So E by V versus delta O by V for D2 complex. D2 complex. So this is the Tanabe-Sugano diagram, and I already said the ground state term is taken as reference. So this 3 T1G for D2, what is the term 3F and 3P? So 3F splitting will be 3F, T1G, T2G, A2G, and for 3P, 3T1G, P. So this is the orbital diagram for D2 system. So in Tanabe-Sugano diagram also the splitting will be same. T1G, T2G, A2G. So 3T1G, 3T2G and 3A2G. See this. 3 splittings of 3F term. So this is taken as 0. So now next term is 3P. So 3P is here. 3T1G, P. And 1D. 1D is what? 1EG and 1T2G. And the energy order of these terms are like this. 3F less than 1D, less than 3P and less than 1G and less than 1S. So this is this order is formed based on Hund's rule and many more factors. So that's not important. Just remember this. 3F less than 1D, less than 3P, less than 1G, less than 1S. So the main important point in Tanabe-Sugano diagram is what? Non-crossing rule. So what is non-crossing rule? Same symmetry will not cross or will not cross each other. Same symmetry means either same symmetry or same multiplicity. Same symmetry or same spin multiplicity. Spin multiplicity. So which are the same symmetry or same spin multiplicity terms here? 3T1G and 3T1G. See this? These are not crossing each other. These are not crossing each other. But here 1T2G. 1T2G is crossing with 3T2G. So these are not same symmetry or same spin multiplicity. But 3T1G F and 3T1G P are not crossing each other. That is called a non-crossing rule. These cannot be cross each other. So this is called a non-crossing rule in Tanabe-Sugano diagram. So TS diagram will be the low spin complexes transitions and the ground state term is taken as constant reference. It is 0 here and non-crossing rule is what? Same symmetry terms are not crossing each other. And E by V versus delta O by V is the plotting. E by V on Y axis and delta O by V on X axis is for TS diagram. So in orbital diagram video, we have seen the ground state term simple, the ground state energy level for high spin octahedral complexes from D1 to D10 configuration. So in Tanabe-Sugano diagram, we will see the low spin octahedral complexes. So in low spin complexes, the only difference is for D4, D5, D6 and D7. Why? From D4, the pairing starts. So in low spin octahedral complexes, if a strong ligand is there, from D4 the pairing starts, different from high spin complexes. So for D4, D5 and D6, D7, the ground state term symbol and the energy level is different from high spin complexes. And for rest of the configuration, it is same as high spin complexes. So I already discussed about D1 to D10 high spin term symbol in order diagram video. So we used D, F, F, D, S code for easy for the shortcut for finding the ground state term symbol. So you can use that shortcut. And the only point to remember here is just by heart this D4, D5, D7 in low spin octahedral complexes. So for D4, 3 T1G and D5, 2 T2G. So in orbital diagram, in high spin octahedral complexes, the D5 was 6 A1G. So here it is different, 2 T2G. So just by heart, D4, D5, D6, D7. So D1, 2 T2G, D2, 3 T1G, same as octahedral high spin complexes. D3, 4 A2G, D4, 3 T1G, D5, 2 T2G, D6, 1 A1G, and D7, 2 EG. So D8, 3 A2G, same as high spin, D9, 1 EG, and D10, 1 A1G. So just by heart, D4, D5, D6, D7. So these are the ground state term symbol for low spin octahedral complexes. For high spin octahedral complexes, it's very easy. D1 to D10, use DFFDS code. So dynamic superhero diagram can explain both high spin and low spin electronic transition in octahedral and tetrahedral complexes. And it can predict the band, the electronic transition and the DQ value or 10 delta O value, CFSC value. And another important point is non-crossing rule. So what is non-crossing rule? Same symmetry or same spin multiplicity terms are not crossing each other in TS diagram. And the difference between Oracle and TS diagram is in x-axis, in y-axis we use E by B and in x-axis delta O by B. In orbital diagram there was not a constant reference, but in TS diagram we take the ground state energy level as the constant reference or taken as 0.